All right, and with that, we bring in Pennsylvania Congressman Keith Rothfus, who was on the ground near the shooting in the aftermath of this and is now headed to one of the hospitals that some of the victims have been taken with. Congressman, first of all, our condolences. We know there are friends and family and constituents who will be grieving over the next days, weeks, months, years, some families for the rest of their lives. Your thoughts on what you saw and what you can add?
Well, this is a horrific day for Pittsburgh. It's a horrific day for the Jewish community. It's a horrific day for the country. I heard about the shooting and wanted to get over as close as I could. There are a number of officials there, the mayor, the county executive, Senator Casey, Governor Wolf, Congressman Doyle, Congressman Lamb. We all, again, to stand in solidarity with the community on this horrific day that we're all reeling from.
When you were there, give us a sense of the emotion. You obviously had the police doing their job. Had the community begun to flood down to the synagogue to check on relatives? Were people still in shock? Describe it for us.
There's a very, very secure perimeter around the facility, a significant number of police presence, incredibly professional work that they were doing, and a lot of anxious families not gathering in any particular location, but again, this was a synagogue where there was a religious service going on. You're supposed to be safe in a place of worship. You should never have this kind of terror anywhere, and to see what one individual could seemingly do is just shocking.
Congressman, undoubtedly this community will be indelibly changed going forward from today, but can you tell us a little bit about Squirrel Hill before today? Tell us about what the folks who lived there were like. Tell us about the community.
Squirrel Hill is a wonderful community, significant Jewish population within the community, not exclusively Jewish, but significant population. Near the universities, near the Carnegie Mellon University, it's a very wonderful, diverse community, close-knit, good families. I actually had a meeting. It's not in my district. It's in the city of Pittsburgh. It's Congressman Doyle's district, but we certainly have a lot of friends in the Squirrel Hill area, and it's just a wonderful community, and to have something like this happen is very difficult.
Have you witnessed anything similar, anything on this scale in terms of shooting violence in the area before?
You know, several years ago, we had an individual, I believe, kill five people going from one place to another, targeting minorities. That was 15, 20 years ago. But to see a particular community singled out like the Jewish community, and I, again, we'll have to take a look at how the Jewish community has been. This may be the worst attack on the Jewish community ever in the United States. I don't know if that's the fact, but again, I don't recall anything like this.
Congressman, the president said on the tarmac at Andrews that something has to be done. Any ideas on the something?
Gosh, you think you take a look at what, and again, you're just getting these little pieces that are coming out of what this alleged shooter may have been saying on social media and where this kind of hatred could come from. We have to take a close look and see where this individual went off the rails the way he did.
Yeah, I want to get back to your time there down next to the perimeter and next to this synagogue. So often in cases like this, family members are plagued by the fear of the unknown, is that, you know that your family member headed to synagogue this morning, but either he didn't take his cell phone because it is Shabbat, or their cell phone got dropped as the person ran out when the shots began to ring out. The cell phone networks are overwhelmed. The lack of information is terrifying for so many of us, as we know that there are multiple fatalities. Were there people starting to stream down to...
No, they were not. I think people were staying in their homes. There was concern that the shooter might have gotten out at one time, so everybody was advised to stay in their homes.
Okay.
But as I've said elsewhere today, today we are all Squirrel Hill. Squirrel Hill is this wonderful community, and to stand in solidarity with them, to be united in broken hearts is what we are today. The Psalms of David say that the Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and we are all brokenhearted today.
Well, that is what the vice president said as he opened his remarks in Las Vegas. And as you point out, communities like this have a unique ability to come together, whether it is Newtown in the wake of the tragedy there, the Orlando community after the Pulse nightclub shooting. As we have covered these, sadly, around the country, out of the worst part of the human equation, and what this shooting was is the worst part of the human equation, often comes the very best in the human equation, which is what you just talked about, sir.
Yeah, and it's going to be a long time of healing here.
Yeah.
Do you have a message, Congressman, for your constituents and people across the state as to how they can help support this small community in Squirrel Hill?
Absolutely. Keep people in your prayers and just stay tuned to see what funds might be established to help the families here. But this is a time for solidarity. It's a time to be united. It's a time for people to really reach out.
And we're about to hear imminently here from President Trump. And what do you think his message is going to be for this community?
I would expect it to be a very similar message. We had this situation a couple of days ago with these bombs being sent around, and the president was very forceful in condemning that activity. And we have to condemn this violence.
He talked
and the hatred that would generate such violence.
He talked earlier, about the time for hate coming to an end. He seems, quite frankly, like he's fed up. When he spoke before and after his arrival in Indianapolis, can you tell me how the events of the past week are weighing on him?
I think they're weighing on all of us. We need to be looking for opportunities to get every American, as I say, back in the game again. This country was founded on some beautiful principles in our founding documents, the Declaration of Independence, the Constitution. Freedom of religion is one of those. It's the first freedom mentioned in either document. And to see people who were practicing their faith today apparently being attacked because of that faith. You can take a look at motives, but this shooting happened at a synagogue during a service.
Yeah.
Just not acceptable.